My name is Dr. Jess McIver, so I'm a senior postdoc here at Caltech working for the LIGO laboratory. So I think about gravitational wave astrophysics, and I also think about the noise in the LIGO detectors. So you have these two compact objects, black holes, neutron stars, and they're orbiting around each other, and they're radiating away gravitational waves. So they're radiating energy away in the form of gravitational waves. And as they do this, their orbit decreases so that sound, the pitch, the frequency, is increasing until they merge. So, whoop. Well, there's more than one kind of chirp. It could go whoop, or it could go whoop, or, and so I sort of mimicked from a low mass system, and that we call it the chirp mass. So it's some function of the product of the two masses and the sum of the two component masses, the two objects that are spinning around and coalescing. And that governs the evolution of the chirp over time. And it's that signature that we can use to infer what the masses are. And from once we know what the masses are, we can use that to infer what the objects are. General relativity predicts the form that these waves should have. So if I have two black holes or two neutron stars, then I can use general relativity to calculate exactly what that waveform should look like. And what's really cool about gravitational waves is, unlike light, where you expect light to be interfered with by dust or other light, gravitational waves will propagate largely unaffected through very vast distances. So we can tell that a signal is likely to be a neutron star black hole, or two neutron stars merging, or two black holes merging, because the signature of the masses of these objects is imprinted on the waves.